I said, no, I want to hear what you've got to say. He said, why? Because I don't believe what the Republicans say about the Democrats, or what the Democrats say about the Republicans, or what the Republicans say about communists. I want to hear from a communist what communism is. He says, you can say. Then when he got through speaking, I said, I want to ask you 1,000 questions. He says, you'll have to go to the YCL. I said, what's that? Young Communist League. Where are they? He gave me an address, and I went there. And the kids from 10 years old to 17 were reading very good, excellent books, like Crime and Punishment, children reading those books. They were brighter than other kids. So during the question period, I raised my hand. I said, how would you prevent corruption under communism? He said, well, when that time comes, we'll deal with it. How are you going to house the millions of people? Oh, when that time comes, we'll deal with it. I said, let's start a technical branch. He said, you're a deviationist. You'll have to leave. You're deviating from the teachings of Marx. I said, I'm only trying to help. I'd help any organization, anywhere in the world. I don't prize any. That they made me leave. So the vice president of the Young Communist Party said, let's hear him out. And they kicked us both out. But they were stupid because I didn't go there to hurt them. I just want to know how you're going to prevent corruption. They had no way of doing it. The only way you can do it is do away with money. So you can't pay anybody off. And just make things available to people. Then they don't steal. If I can get a radio and TV set, have the access set, I'm not going to break into your house and take it. Or hit you on the head and take your watch. It's cheaper to give a guy a watch than put him in prison. You understand?